Spanish video and MP3 lessons with Laura Garrido Eslava.
Parecer and Parecerse.
We are going to learn the different uses of the Spanish verb parecer and parecerse. We use parecer to talk about the appearance of something or someone. So if you want to say Ana seems tired, you'll say Ana parece cansada. Ana parece cansada. Or if you want to say you seem younger than you are, in Spanish you'll say Pareces más joven de lo que eres. Pareces más joven de lo que eres. We'll use parecerse when we talk about similarities. So if you want to say Elena and Sonia look very alike, in Spanish you'll say Elena y Sonia se parecen mucho. Elena y Sonia se parecen mucho. Or if you want to say I look like my mother, you'll say Me parezco a mi madre. Me parezco a mi madre. And if you want to ask and give opinions, you'll use the verb parecer in the third person of the verb with an indirect object pronoun, like the verb gustar. So if you want to say, what do you think of the film? In Spanish you'll say, ¿qué te parece la película? ¿Qué te parece la película? And if you want to answer, I think it is very entertaining. In Spanish you'll say, me parece que es muy divertida. Me parece que es muy divertida. When you are giving your opinion about what someone else is doing, you can use this structure. You'll say me parece, after you say the adjective, then you say que, que, and the verb after will have to be in subjuntivo. Let's see some examples. If you want to say, I think it's great that you are going to Barcelona. In Spanish, you'll say, Me parece muy bien que vayas a Barcelona. Me parece muy bien que vayas a Barcelona. If you want to say, I think it's awful that Antonio hasn't studied at all. In Spanish, you'll say, Me parece fatal que Antonio no haya estudiado nada. Me parece fatal que Antonio no haya estudiado nada. And if you want to say, I think it's fantastic that you have won the lottery. In Spanish you'll say, Me parece fantástico que hayas ganado la lotería. Me parece fantástico que hayas ganado la lotería. But when you are giving your opinion in general, then you'll put me parece after you put an adjective, and then the verb will have to be in infinitive. Let's see some examples. If you want to say, I think going to the beach is boring. In Spanish you'll say, me parece aburrido ir a la playa. Me parece aburrido ir a la playa. And if you want to say, I think studying medicine is interesting. In Spanish you'll say, Me parece interesante estudiar medicina. Me parece interesante estudiar medicina. And if you want to say, I think living in Spain is marvelous. In Spanish you'll say, Me parece maravilloso vivir en España. Me parece maravilloso vivir en España. If you want to say he looks like or she looks like, in Spanish you'll say se parece a. Se parece a. To say he's similar in or she, in Spanish you'll say se parece en. Se parece en. If you want to say Anna is similar to her father in character. Then you'll say, Anna se parece a su padre en el carácter. Anna se parece a su padre en el carácter. Then if you want to say he or she is identical to, you have different ways to say that. You can say, es idéntico a... Es idéntico a... Or you could say, es clavado a... Es clavado a... Or another way to say is, es igual a... Es igual a... Remember that if you are talking about a woman or about a female item, then you'll have to say idéntica rather than idéntico, or clavada rather than clavado. Let's see one example with this. If you want to say Pedro is identical to his brother, in Spanish you say Pedro es clavado a su hermano. Pedro es clavado a su hermano. If you want to say they are like two peas in a pod, Spanish you'll say son como dos gotas de agua. Son como dos gotas de agua. And if you want to say that he or she doesn't look like someone, in Spanish you'll say no se parece a... No se parece a... And if you want to say that he doesn't look like someone at all, then you'll say, no se parece en nada a... No se parece en nada a...